Hello guys and dolls, and welcome back to Beauty Inside a Box. Today I have a little bit of a different video for you. It's not a doll review. Today I'm going to be talking about my thoughts and opinions on the new 2018 Bratz Collectors line. I am so excited. The Bratz are finally back. I love the Bratz. I've loved the Bratz ever since they first came out, and I'm really glad that we're getting these new dolls. And these dolls, in my opinion, look flawless. They look amazing. I think it's so nice that MGA and Isaac Larian have decided to listen to the Bratz fans and creating a line which is specifically for them. I think that's really cool. And the fact that he got Hayden Williams, an incredible, talented artist, involved, and also a Bratz fan himself, I think that was such a brilliant idea, and they've really, made such an incredible line of dolls. So I'm gonna talk about them. Let me first start off by saying one of the things that I always loved about the Bratz when I was a kid was how cool their clothes were, how well dressed they were. I always thought they looked so cool, all the way up till about 2010. And then with their first reboot, I really thought the clothes were awful. I thought they looked really tacky and mismatched, and I didn't really like them. And then in 2015, their clothes were slightly better, but still not great. Everything they wore was really garish, bright colors, mismatched patterns. It was awful. So one of the things I'm most excited about for these dolls is the fact that they're finally wearing really cool clothes, because the Bratz were always like the cool, funky, sassy alternative to Barbie in my eyes. But let's move on to talking about the dolls individually. So the Bratz official Instagram account has been slowly giving us little teasers, and now recently we finally started getting full images of the dolls, and I am gagging. First of all, we got Sasha. This doll honestly has everything I would want in a doll. First of all, you know, fashionable clothes, super long hair, articulation in the legs. Well, I'm hoping they have articulation in the legs. You can't really see here, but it looks like they probably will. She's got really nice, intricate clothes. All the dolls in this new line do. They've even got material bags, which is something we haven't seen for a really long time. And it looks like there's gonna be loads of detail. I can really imagine seeing this outfit on ASOS or something. I love the big puffy jacket. I think it's so cool. It reminds me of like something Rihanna would wear, like part of her Puma line. She's got these incredible piercing green eyes, which are just amazing. She looks so gorgeous. I think the makeup is really nice. It's very modern. I've seen people online complaining a little bit about the makeup, saying that they want more, but I think it's just the right amount. People have also complained about the fact that Sasha is looking straight ahead instead of like the slight kind of flirty side eye that the Bratz normally have. But I actually like her looking straight ahead. Some of the other dolls in the line are doing the kind of side eye, so I think it's good to have a bit of a mix. I really like her hat. She's got what looks like a kind of snapback. All the colors are really nice and harmonious. I think her jeans are really cool, and that hair is so long. I love it, and it looks like it's gonna be like quite nice quality hair as well. So I'm so ready for this doll. I'm wondering how much they're gonna cost. I'm guessing they're gonna be about £30, $30, but you know, they could be anywhere between like 25 to 50, I would say, because they just look, you know, so nice. Put in the comments what you think the pricing is gonna be on these dolls. Okay, so the next doll that we got a picture for on the official Bratz Instagram account was Yasmin, and I like this one. She's not my favorite. I'll tell you why in a minute. Lots of people online I saw were complaining about the boots, the fact that they're kind of in two sections, but the Bratz actually used to do that quite a lot, I guess because it's quite hard to connect them and also make it possible for the feet to snap off. That does annoy me slightly, but I'm not too fussed about it. I think the parts of this outfit that I don't really like is I don't like the hat. I think the hat looks kind of tacky. I don't like the faux snake skin bit in the middle. I mean, what I quite like about it is it's very reminiscent of what the Bratz wore when they were the Rock Angels, and I think that's quite cool, and I wonder if that was intentional. I think her makeup looks great. I like the soft lips. I quite like the jacket. It's very long. It's very cool. I don't like the frilly sleeves on the top. I think it's going to be part of the top and not part of the jacket. Yeah, I'm not a massive fan of them. But the top overall, I do quite like. The skirt, I love. She's got like this, what looks like faux leather skirt with some drawstrings at the front. I think her boots are really cool, even though they are in two separate halves, which is a bit annoying. Her hair looks amazing. Again, it's really long. And this time she's got a bit of a wave to it. Love that. And of course, she's got a real material bag. And you can kind of see from her arm that they are gonna have some articulation, which I love. Articulation is a really important part of any doll for me because it makes them more poseable and that just makes them a lot more fun to play with and to handle. And yeah, Yasmin always used to be my favorite when I was a kid. I used to always buy Yasmin first, except now I actually think I prefer Jade or Sasha more. And especially in this doll, Yasmin is not my favorite, but I still really like her and I think all the pieces of this outfit individually I really like, except for the hat. Don't like the hat. But yeah, what do you guys think of Yasmin? Okay, the next doll we are going to talk about, the next doll which was released on the Bratz Instagram account was Chloe. I think she looks really cool. I actually much prefer the way this doll looks to how the initial illustration looks. I'm kind of getting a better idea of what the outfit is meant to be. I really like her outfit. I think it's really cool. I love her like black and white kind of snakeskin looking boots. Love that. Love her red lips. Love her piercing blue eyes and dark makeup. She looks awesome. Again, not a fan of the hat. I don't understand these hats. They kind of look like railway conductors or something. Don't like it. I quite like the little chain that's going on there. I think that detailing is really cool. But yeah, I'm just not a massive fan of the hat. I don't know why. I just don't like it. I don't like it. It looks kind of tacky to me. Everything else, love. Love the denim dress. Love the like corset. Looks really cool. I love her bag. She's just awesome. Again, her hair looks really beautiful. And the last doll I'm going to talk about, who had her full image released only a couple days ago, is Jade. And I love this outfit. I think it's so cool. I think it's kind of edgy. I love the flames on her jeans. I am just obsessed. I think she might be my favorite. Her and Sasha are definitely my favorites. On this doll, I like the hat. I really like the beret. Again, it's such a classic Bratz thing to have a beret, I feel. It's funny because that kind of 2001 aesthetic is starting to come back into fashion. So this is the perfect time for the Bratz to have a resurgence because, you know, this kind of look, the kind of look that the Bratz were always going for, is really starting to have like a nostalgia-driven resurgence. So I think this is so great. I love her fringe. I love her jet black hair. I love her eye makeup. She's obviously got the little side eye going on. I love her hoop earrings. I think all of them have hoop earrings, which is quite cool. I love her top with the kind of corsety moment going on and then the long strings hanging all the way down to her ankles. So cool, so dramatic, I love it. As I said before, I love the flaming jeans. I love the netting on her arms. She looks awesome. I love her big black boots. And these boots look like they've used the same mold that the Bratz had way back in 2001, which I love. I think that kind of call back to the original Bratz is really awesome. And actually, talking about using old molds, I think the whole doll is using the original mold that they used to use in the noughties. So I think that's really cool. And she's got this little fluffy red bag, which I am living for. I think it's so cute. It's so cool. And it's got a little chain to hold onto it. Love it. I love this outfit. I think it's so awesome. Yes. Yes. Just yes to all of it. Now, there is one more doll that they haven't released an image for yet, as of me filming this video, of course, and that is Cameron. I love the fact that they've joined Cameron into the kind of initial lineup for the Bratz, you know. Good to include different genders in there as well. I love that. And this doll looks like it's gonna be really cool as well. I love his hair, love his sassy pose. He just looks really cool, love his jacket. I cannot wait to see what he's gonna look like in real life. So that was all of my thoughts and opinions on all of the dolls that are coming out individually. Please let me know in the comments what your thoughts are. Let me just say, you are completely entitled to your own opinion on these dolls. In fact, I encourage it. Bratz have had so many come comebacks in recent years. Just since 2010, which is only 8 years ago, they've had like 3 comebacks. And honestly, I think if this line of dolls doesn't do well and doesn't really succeed, then we probably will never see the Bratz again, because MGA will not want to invest in a doll line which has failed so many times in the past. And I think MGA has clearly tried so hard to listen to the fans, and they really want to please everyone, which is very difficult, whilst also making the best possible product they ever could. And I honestly think that's all we could really ask for, that's all we could really hope for. And I think Hayden Williams and MGA have done such a brilliant job with these dolls. I am really impressed. I cannot wait to buy them. I will, of course, be doing full doll reviews of probably all of them on my channel when they come out. So make sure you subscribe so that you get to see those. As of yet, we haven't had any official date for when they're coming out, but I suspect it will probably be end of September, beginning of October. So as I said before, make sure you're subscribed to my channel. Make sure you've clicked that little bell icon so that you can see all my Bratz unboxings when these dolls finally come out. Also, don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it. Let me know your thoughts and feelings in the comments below. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Twitter, and I will see you real soon, Bratz fans. Bye. Bye.